Chimpanzees are our closest living relatives. And the nature documentary watchers among you may know just how astonishingly similar our behaviors can be. But there's one behavior we have in common that most people don't know about. Wild chimpanzees self-medicate using plants. Come with me to the forests of Uganda to discover some wild medicines. I'm Dr. Elodie Freymann, and I'm researching which plants wild chimpanzees store in their foraged medicine cabinets. For 8 months, I became part of the chimpanzees' world, immersing myself in the Budongo forest of Uganda, studying their behaviors. Every day, at the crack of dawn, I met up with my colleagues, the local field staff who are experts at navigating the forest and finding the chimpanzees. Together, we trekked through the forest, tracking the chimpanzees, recording everything they did and ate, and monitoring their health. I was particularly interested in following chimpanzees who are showing signs of infections or injuries, such as chimpanzees who are coughing or sneezing or who had obvious wounds, to see if their behaviors differed from other healthy members of the group. Importantly, I wanted to figure out which plants sick chimpanzees seem to be seeking out. While spending time with the Budongo chimpanzees, I observed some really interesting cases of ill individuals seeking out unusual plant materials, such as ferns, tree bark, and resin, all of which are not part of the normal chimpanzee diet. To understand whether these plants could aid in the individual's recovery, I sent some samples off to New Brandenburg University of Applied Sciences for further analysis. Excitingly, many of our plant samples showed strong bioactivity, with both antibacterial and anti-inflammatory properties. It seems that the Budongo chimpanzees have at least some basic awareness of these plants' healing properties. As it turns out, chimpanzees make excellent doctors. The forest edge is also home to many human communities who also rely on wild plants for food and medicine. Are chimpanzees and local people relying on the same plants? I spoke to a few traditional healers in nearby villages to find out how they use the forest as medicine. Amazingly, there seems to be some overlap between the medicinal plants targeted by chimpanzees and those used in forest edge communities. By observing our wild relatives and the self-medicative resources they consume, we can also develop our own knowledge of this planet's forest pharmacies. This is becoming increasingly important as the world's wild spaces shrink. My hope is that this research will further encourage us to work together to protect precious ecosystems and valuable plant medicines that keep both chimpanzees and humans healthy for generations to come.